Hello, everyone. Welcome to This Day. It is Thursday, and it's February 11th. We do have a couple of meetings to tell you about today. At 9:30 this morning, we do have the United Landscape Committee meeting. And then this afternoon at 1:30, we have the Community Activities Committee. And those are both virtual, so you can follow along at lagunawoodsvillage.com/meetings. Now, on our show today, we have concerned citizens with Marcia and Sue. And then we also will bring you a segment from with Donna with Diane's Hallmark, just in time for Valentine's weekend. They've got lots of great stuff there. And I wanted to tell you a couple of things regarding COVID-19 vaccines. We have a few resources for you. We have the Laguna Woods Village vaccinations, and that is going on usually on the weekends, and you can go to 949-594-2533, which is the hotline, to find out more about that. And then, of course, we have an FAQ page on lagunawoodsvillagealerts.com, where you can find out all the different questions that are surrounding the vaccination program. Then we also have information regarding Kaiser Permanente members. Now, they do have a hotline that you can call, 833-574-2273, if you would like information regarding their vaccination program for their members. Or you can make an appointment on kp.org/COVID vaccine, and you click on make an appointment. So just another resource for our residents. And then, of course, if you want to go to Soka University or Disneyland, you will register at athena.com. And if you want more information about their vaccination distribution, you can go to occovid19.occhealthinfo.com. All right, our weather is looking pretty good for the next couple of days, but we are going to have some clouds moving in towards the weekend, unfortunately. We are partly cloudy, 68.53 today. Tomorrow, we are looking at clouds to start with and PM showers, 65-48. Cloudy on Saturday. And then for our Valentine's Day, we are looking at partly cloudy, but still lovely at 67-46. And Monday, sunshine will be upon us, 68-52. Our sunrise this morning was at 6:39, and our sunset will be at 5:34. Great shot, Alan. Thank you for sending that in. Cool-looking tree. I like the shadows there. Nice job. If you have a photo you'd like to share with us of anything here in the village that is somewhat of a landscape photo, please share it with us and send it to lagunawoodsvillagetv@gmail.com. All right, when we come back, we will have concerned citizens. Stay tuned.
People with hearing loss only know the way they hear, not how much better they should be hearing. How well are you hearing? Are you understanding 60% or maybe only 30%? You don't know unless someone measures your hearing understanding ability. People are wearing hearing aids that are underfit with power, not programmed properly, the physical fit is too loose or too tight. Find out what your understanding score is with a special word test from Advanced Ear Care. Stop in today and tell them Stuart sent you.
Welcome back. Well, today I am joined by Marcia and Sue, and they are with Concerned Citizens. Well, ladies, thank you for joining me. How are you today?
Very well.
Good, good. Well, we've been seeing your show now for some time, and I just wanted our folks here to get to know you individually, and you know what kind of brought you to Concerned Citizens show. So, Marcia, I'm going to start with you. Can you give me a brief background on kind of what brought you to the show?
Okay. Well, the club was founded in 1981, so we just missed being able to celebrate our 40th anniversary, but we hope to do that at some time. And initially it was around peace, but times changed. We have nuclear non-proliferation treaties now, and we have other social problems, economic inequality and mass incarceration, what have you. So we have meetings, or we had meetings once a month, a big meeting, and those were often videographed and shown on television.
Right.
Well, then the COVID came, so no more meetings, no more getting together. And we have what's called Concerned Citizens Presents now, which is on every Wednesday on Village TV at 1 o'clock. And we have usually two speakers a month, sometimes three, and Sue interviews them. Sometimes there's a canned speech, but usually she does a good job interviewing them. And they talk about things that we're interested in, social justice, climate change, economic inequality, the things that are on the minds of a lot of people today, things that harm people.
So. Right. Now, so if the club has been around for 40 years, how long have you been involved?
I've been involved since 2002 when we were snowbirds for 8 years, but I always participated in the clubs. We were here winters and summers, so a while.
Okay, and Sue, how about you?
Well, I also started as a snowbird around 2009, just attending in the winter, and then I moved here in 2014.
Okay. And then, so what brought, Sue, what brought you to the club?
Well, I think it was really the programs. I saw a flyer at Clubhouse One in 2009 about a book discussion that was going to be held about a very, exciting, timely topic. And I've always been interested in politics and economics. I am a retired sociologist. So these kinds of issues have been my life's work. So I began attending and I thought it was terrific.
Well, that is great. Now, does the club, does it matter whether you are one party or another, or is it made up of all different parties?
It's not political at all. It's concerned with issues.
Okay.
So anybody is welcome to come, and sometimes we take a position on something that relates perhaps to legislation or policies of the government, but it's not a political organization per se.
Okay. Well, boy, has this year given you plenty to talk about. Holy smokes. You guys, I mean, you have content for quite some time, I think. You're in good shape for sure. Let's talk a little bit about, Sue, so you do primarily the interviewing, is that correct?
Well, we have actually a variety of programs. We have sometimes a speaker with a canned speech, like we had, do you remember when we had the homelessness issue about the Ayers Hotel?
Oh yeah.
Well, just around that time, we managed to get Dr. David Snow at UCI, who had done a study for United Way on homelessness in Orange County. Now, he had a canned speech. He had PowerPoint slides, and I didn't have to do very much. That was kind of easy for me. He went through his routine. He'd given the talk before, or at least some version of it. Then we have other kinds of programs, like the one that's running right now, where the speaker, I'm working with Detective Debbie Ramsey. She's a retired Baltimore police detective, and obviously the Black Lives Matter demonstrations and the police violence was what triggered that. And in her case, as was the case with Dr. Snow, I said, well, would you like to do a canned talk? Would you like to have slides? Would you like to talk to me? Would you like a bunch of people asking you questions? And then they choose. So Ms. Ramsey chose why don't we do an interview? Of course, they get the questions in advance. But that's another example.
Yeah, well, and like you said, there have been issues that have arose where it's like a light bulb for you guys. Oh, you know what? We should talk about this. Let's find somebody about this. Now, Marcia, one thing that you mentioned in your notes is about Zoom. Now, I've talked to so many different hosts now of all the different shows. Zoom has been a godsend because we can now interview people that we would never have originally because they're not going to drive here and be in the studio.
That's right. It's expanded our reach because usually a speaker would come from as far as LA, San Diego, but they had to be, or they happened to be in the area. The other thing about Zoom, the Zoom things are taped and then they're put on YouTube. So if you missed the Wednesday presentation, you can go to our website and they're all there and with links to all the programs that are out on YouTube. So nothing nothing is lost. It's you get really much more access to everything that we do.
Yeah, and same with most of our programs is they're on the YouTube channel, and that's always nice to be able to go back because not everybody has the opportunity to watch the show at that exact moment. So that's exactly. Kind of great. That's great. Now, go ahead.
If I might just interject another point I want to praise Village TV is that when we were having in-person programs, as Marcia indicated, we would might have them recorded, but actually we had to pay for that and we had to set it up. We had to hire, a Village TV technician to come and tape it and so forth.
Right.
But now, I don't know how long this will go on, but Village TV has been wonderful to us because essentially they give us an hour every week. And what we usually do, we do one show for 2 weeks and then, we run a different one. And we're not paying anything. So we think this is a pretty good deal.
We've even suspended our dues.
Well, I think it just depends. I mean, sometimes at the very beginning, you have a paid situation and then once it's established, and obviously with the whole COVID thing, things have changed a lot for everybody. Mm-hmm. But you know what? Content is great, and content is what our residents request. And certainly your show is watched, and people have great information, and I hope that you are hearing from your residents or the people that are actually watching the show, like yay or nay, or boy, we'd like to talk about this and that kind of thing. Do you have a means for them to get in touch with you?
Not a lot of feedback. One of the things about the old day, the before times, it was a chance for us to all get together. There was coffee and cookies and big round tables, and you could talk with people about the things that were going on. And nobody's seen any live people in a long time, and I think that's a big loss. Yeah. And then some members are not that good with computers to be able to get on the website and look at the things that we offer there. So it's a loss, the loss of the human contact, which we'll get back eventually. But
well, that's true. But Lisa, we do get some feedback because one of the publicity gimmicks, we use many publicity avenues, obviously. Marcia writes wonderful publicity for us. And one of the things that happens is a day or two before broadcast, we send everyone an email blast that Marcia composes, a short reminder. Yet again, it's not the only reminder they've gotten that show will be on. And very often, so you can reply to that message. We have someone in charge of sending and receiving, and it kind of comes through our website. I'm not sure about the technology, but we do get feedback. People write back. To be honest, sometimes they write back and they say, oh, my view is that this person that you've interviewed is misinformed, or you didn't think about this or that. But most of the time, people are praising us and saying that they really enjoyed it. Although, of course, as Marcia points out, not everybody even has access to computers or is as comfortable with them. So there's doubtless some silent folks out there as well.
Well, right. Now, I know you have a website and you have a newsletter. Now, what if somebody, should they just go to the website if they want to participate, or do you have an email address for more information?
Well, the easiest thing to do would be to go on the village, LagunaWoodsVillage.com, to clubs.
Okay.
And it's alphabetical. You go down to concerned citizens, and that will connect you to our website. So they don't need to worry about memorizing another website. And from there, you'll find the newsletter, you'll find our calendar, you'll find the link to the old programs. And if you want to contact us, you can do it through the website. The website's been, and the newsletter, just while we're talking about our media, expanded so much because when it's online, we don't mail them. Nobody's getting together to fold and mail things. It can be any length. So we have longer articles and we have links to other organizations and things through the newsletter. So it opens up
and links
the world
to our
in even
program.
More ways because of the
It's kind of nice because when you're on the computer, it's super easy just to click on that little link, you know, rather than having to do it another way. Okay, so one last thing, Sue, I know you've got some people coming up. Just quickly tell me who they are for your next couple shows.
Okay, well, as I mentioned, right now we're showing Debbie Ramsey, but I would like to put in a plug for March, which is Women's History Month, and we will be featuring Jane Stover, who is a well-known activist against domestic violence. She's a professor at UCI, and Vivian Klesak, who is the founder of Human Options, also a wonderful organization helping women in distress. And these two women are experts on domestic abuse. They will be discussing patterns of family violence before and during COVID, because as we know, unfortunately, now that people are locked in their homes, domestic violence is one of those social problems that's increasing.
Exactly. Well, that sounds awesome. And I really appreciate both of you joining me today.
It was a pleasure to meet you. Thank you.
Well, we certainly thank you for your interest in our activities.
All right. Well, we look forward to seeing you guys again. Good luck with your show.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye. And we'll be right back after this.
At Pro Smiles OC, you get Orange County's best and most experienced dentist. Dr. Ivan Ho is an award-winning cosmetic and implant dentist that has been treating patients in South OC and Laguna Woods for over 30 years. Safety and cleanliness is our number one priority, and now your routine dental work is more comfortable than ever. We use digital x-rays to minimize radiation and digital scans for crowns and inlays in-house, allowing patients to leave with final restorations in the same appointment. Let Dr. Ho and his team give you a reason to smile. Call Pro Smiles OC today.
Welcome to the Meridian at Laguna Hills, a newly multi-million dollar renovated community. Located in beautiful southern Orange County, the Meridian at Laguna Hills blends quality senior care onto the bright canvas of Laguna Hills life. With a luxurious five-star resort style community and a dedication to resident care, you can experience an exquisite senior lifestyle unlike any other. Discover a community filled with care and the freedom to pursue what matters most. It's a new day and it's yours. Make the most of it at the Meridian at Laguna Hills.
Welcome back. Well, today I have a first-timer here with us and also first-time to Zoom. We have Donna Holter, who is here on behalf of Diane's Hallmark. Well, hi. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Lisa, for having me today.
Oh, you're welcome. And I know you're coming to us from the store and out of safety precautions. You wanted to keep your mask on, and I think that's just awesome. And I love all the teddy bears behind you. Just adorable.
Yes, we are ready for Valentine's Day.
That's awesome. You know, tell me a little bit about what it's like to have a store like this.
So the store has been here 25 years, and it's a safe place. It's a place where we just welcome everybody. It's a neighborhood store, a lot of repeat customers. A lot of our friends from Laguna Wood come to our store, and we're so thankful for their business. We've got a women's boutique. We have a Christian center. We have general gifts throughout the store, and then we have all of our core Hallmark cards. And that's what brings people in, are the Hallmark cards.
Right. You know, there aren't very many stores these days that carry all those kinds of things you do.
Right. And that's what I'm hearing more and more all the time. So I feel like we're kind of the last man standing. But because of Laguna Woods and our having been here 25 years, we've been able to withstand COVID closure for 9 weeks. And we were closed for 9 weeks. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's just, it's amazing that we're still here, so.
Well, yeah, and even so, with a lot of online buying these days as well, you know, a lot of people have been just forced to do a lot of online buying. But what you are relaying is that people still like to come in, they like to touch and feel things to buy, and like you said, the cards. So how do you feel, you know, what is it that you think people are in finding so important to come into the store rather than buying something online?
Well, like having the contact with other people, coming in and talking, coming in and seeing and touching. You know, the music we play are from the 50s, and so all of this music has really profound memories for people, and they have stories about these songs. And you know, I see people all the time kind of dancing and singing and with the store. So the music almost is more important than what we have, because it's just a great community family store. Exactly. And people just feel welcomed. And that's our whole goal, is to just, you know, make it a place where people can come, even if they don't buy anything, they can just come in and relax. You know, there's so much stress in the world, and it's just a safe place to come.
That's awesome. I remember coming into your store one time because I had heard that you had the Josephs that you plant in the front of your yard when you want to sell your house.
Yep. We still do.
I love it, you know, because those are not easy to find. And so that worked out great when I came in there. Tell me some of the other specialty things that you think really draw people to your store other than the cards.
Okay, so our vast variety of puzzles. Right now, puzzles are hot, hot, hot. So in the background, you can see some of our Valentine puzzles. Mm-hmm. We have a huge array of Christian gifts, angels, Bibles, books, daily devotionals, journals. We have women's apparel, funny, crazy socks, slippers. We have willow tree collection is probably one of our best-selling items in the store for like 18 years.
Wow.
And then just kind of a little bit of everything. I mean, that's our goal.
That's great. That's great.
I know. Old guys rule. Old guys rule t-shirts are huge.
Oh, the old guys rule t-shirts. Oh, I bet all those dudes from Laguna Woods are flocking over there.
They collect them. Yeah. Yeah.
I love it. I love it. Well, you know, best wishes to you. And in closing, is there any last words you'd like to let our residents know?
Well, that we are so grateful for their business. We're here. We are doing everything we can to keep the store safe and clean and healthy. One thing I haven't implemented was maybe hours. If some of our residents don't feel comfortable coming in during regular 10 to 7 hours, I'd be happy to just come in at 9 on a day during the week if people would feel more comfortable just coming in by themselves. Okay. We do curbside pickup. We do online. So hopefully, however people feel most comfortable is what we'll do. We're here to serve you.
Oh, that's great. So, thank you so much, Donna. Very nice to meet you online, and good luck to you.
Oh, thank you.
All right.
Have a great day.
Thank you. And we'll be right back after this.
At Diane's Hallmark, we're ready for Valentine's Day. Are you? Come in and see our great selection of cards and gifts. We have everything you need to show that special someone how much you care. And don't forget those grandkids either. Diane's Hallmark has many cards and gifts for them as well. Diane's Hallmark is located in the Marketplace Center, right next to Hobby Lobby. We have something for everyone. Come in today and take care of all your Valentine's Day needs.
I started Sterling Financial under the premise that there was a need for integrity in this industry as well as quality service.
There's such volatility in the stock market. One day it could be up 100 points, the next day it could be down 500 points. Well, what we like to do is be able to have people go to bed and wake up the next morning knowing that their money is safe and secure.
That's what we try to do here at Sterling Financial Advisors, is to create peace of mind and quality of life in retirement.
Back. We have just a few announcements for you. I wanted to remind you of the emails that we have available to you. For starters, if you have a new email or a new phone number, it is requested that you send that information to residentservices@vmsinc.org. And you want the latest information there, especially if they're going to contact you for a vaccination opportunity. Then, if you are a retired medical professional, we are in need of people to sit with the vaccine recipient to make sure that they are okay after receiving the vaccine. If you are one of those folks that would like to volunteer to help us out, we ask that you please send a note to info@lagunawoodsvillage.com. Now, there's something exciting going on in our community, and Assemblywoman Cottie Petrie Norris is requesting that if you know of a woman who has made a significant difference in the community of either Costa Mesa, Huntington Beach, Irvine, Laguna Beach, Laguna Woods, or Newport Beach, that you please nominate this individual, and you would send the information to the website that is listed here. They will have a place for you to send that to. It's a74.asmdc.org/WOD. And that nomination is due by February 19th of this year. All right, also, the Video Club is doing a contest, if you will. They're asking for submissions of short videos, and all of them will be compiled, and they're having a Zoom meeting on Thursday, February 18th at 7 p.m., and it's open to all residents on Zoom. There'll be 10 original 4-minute videos submitted by the club members on different subjects, and the winners will be selected by the vote of the members in advance, so you will be able to see these videos. So if you want to participate, send a note to videoclubofLagunaWoods@gmail.com, and in the subject line, mention video contest. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at our weather one last time. It's looking okay until potentially tomorrow, where we might start having some showers. So we are seeing some increasing clouds starting tomorrow, but the weather's looking okay. Today, partly cloudy, 68, 53. Tomorrow, clouds with increasing cloudiness and showers, 65, 48. And then Saturday, cloudy, 63, 42. Sunday, partly cloudy, 67, 46. And Monday, sunshine, 68, 52. So hang in there. The rain will come and go, and we'll still have a nice weekend, we hope. All right. Have a great day in the village. We'll be back again tomorrow here on Friday at 9 a.m. Otherwise, you can watch our show again at 12:30 and 5 p.m. Have a great day in the village. We'll see you again tomorrow. Bye-bye.
A level of comfort you've never known before. The Daydreamer will take you through smooth movements and guide you effortlessly into your favorite positions. Adjust the power pillow for ideal support for your head and neck. This and our positioning technology allows for infinite relaxation. Lay back in zero gravity while watching TV and put your body and mind at ease. Lift your spirits and find your favorite daydream. Contact your local Golden retailer today.
For the sweaty faces and the hidden smiles, the foggy glasses and the sore ears, the determined looks and the muffled laughs. A simple piece of fabric makes a big statement. I care. Let's all do our part to slow the spread. Wear a mask. Learn more at covid19.ca.gov.
At Harvard Eye, we're so happy to be open again to see you for all of your medical and surgical eye care. We're taking great care to protect everyone from COVID-19 by seeing fewer patients, spacing out chairs in the lobby, sanitizing our office constantly, and doing much more. The world is changing a lot, but what hasn't changed is we're honored by your trust and confidence and committed to keeping you safe. We can't wait to see you again.